ain't high school, man. You're at a new level here. You have not earned teammate status yet.
Who the hell are you?
Oh, Jake Bradford.
And until you do, you're nobody.
Hi, everybody. I'm Tim Estidos with The Spiel and Entertainment, and I'm here with actors Blake Jenner, Tyler Hoechlin, and also Will Britton to talk about their great new comedy, Everybody Wants Some.
I'd like to introduce you to the new guys.
Two rules.
No booze in this house.
Number two, no girls upstairs in those bedrooms.
I'm seriously worried about these new guys. Oh!
Play a good game, man.
All right, now it looks like you guys definitely are having a good time with this film. What was it like?
Oh, it's too much fun.
Pretty much what you see in the film. That was one of the coolest things, actually, when we all got to watch it back for the first time was, I know Rick was really wanting us to see it when it felt like it captured what kind of what we had gone through shooting it, and it really did. I mean, we had the best time shooting it. I think it really kind of came through on the screen, which was really great.
We have a little tradition welcoming the new guys.
Freshman batting practice!
Welcome to the big time, boys.
The core theme of the film is you guys are all taking sort of this passage into unsupervised young adulthood in college. Mm-hmm. You know, so on that theme level for you guys personally, was there something that you could relate to?
Well, with me, with my character being a freshman coming in, I went straight from high school to LA to pursue acting. Mm-hmm. So I never had that college experience. So I kind of tapped back into that void and kind of treated this like, all right, you know, getting to know these guys, shooting this movie. You know, this is kind of like the freshman year that I never had, or like weekend before freshman year that I never had. So that was kind of what I was playing with.
Yeah, and for me, I remember I came from a small town in Northeast Texas. So when I gone to school at UT, coming to Austin, Texas, and being influenced by all these different cultures and people and a student population of 50,000 when I come from a town that has 9,000 in population, which is sort of like overwhelming, to say the least, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think the thing that was actually really funny with playing McReynolds was I remember going to school and playing college ball, and when baseball was a part of your life as an athlete, I think there's a very strong sense of identity, and like that is kind of your world, and you grow up in a way that maybe some people in college haven't yet because they're still finding what they want to do, whereas as an athlete you know what you want to do. So I remember in college actually when I was playing baseball feeling like I knew more who I was then maybe than I did like once I stopped playing ball and kind of had to rediscover that. Yeah. So there was like a certainty with Mac being a third year guy and knowing that he was kind of like the man on the team. There's a very kind of blind arrogance and ignorance that goes into that of thinking like, I know exactly who I am and what my life is going to be.
Look at what we have here.
Hey, ladies.
Party later tonight at the baseball houses.
You should be investing this energy elsewhere.
Lesbians.
I like the quiet guy in the backseat.
Oh, there's nothing here.
Yeah, I can see how that could get threatening. New guy coming in, getting all the ladies.
That was a joke.
I got your joke right here.
Did he just call it a joke?
That's what he implied.
Well, you know what's interesting about this film is that the college generation or the young people of today are incredibly politically correct.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
The 80s were anything but politically correct.
Anything but,
so, you know,
right.
Was there anything about going through this process, learning about the 80s that surprised you in terms of that whole aspect?
Well, I think to some degree, it was nice that it wasn't so politically correct. You know, it wasn't, people didn't take things too seriously.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. There wasn't, there
that
were,
aspect
weren't
of it
looking
nice.
To be offended. Like,
right,
there was
people,
something genuinely
exactly.
offensive than it was. But I feel like a lot of times being politically correct today, it's almost like you're aware that people are just actively seeking a comment to pick apart and
right.
turn
mm-hmm.
it into something that it's not yeah. intended to be. But that was the more relaxed setting of living in that for a minute.
Yeah.
How did you know what room I was in?
I'm an investigative journalism major.
So I guess you know my name then.
Yes. As soon as you tell me.
You know, Richard Linklater, the director, he brought you guys together for a boot camp, I understand. What was that like?
Oh, it was grueling. I mean, like, Army boot camp has nothing on what we went through.
But it was a boot camp to learn about the 80s.
Yeah.
So it was a different kind of boot camp.
It was a blast, honestly.
No, it was awesome.
It was filled with disco dancing lessons in the morning and baseball practice and the after that, and followed by probably 4 hours of script work that was just probably the most fun that we had. You know,
yeah.
I think baseball would be the most fun, but honestly, working through the script was probably more fun than that.
And we would even keep up working on the script, even like going to our cabin and not being around Rick. Like, we'd run through it, see how much we had memorized, play with stuff, talk about certain scenes.
As young actors that are, you know, your careers are getting started, you're getting a chance to work in this film with, you know, the esteemed director, Richard Linklater. Mm-hmm. So I'm not going to ask you what it was like to work with him. I'm going to ask you what you learned from working with him.
Well, we were just talking about this a little while ago. I think anyone, and all of us do, all of us love to write and stuff. Anyone who like has aspirations of, you know, writing in the future, like directing in the future, just working with him, it was kind of, I know we were actors working on a film, but it kind of felt like we were shadowing him at the same time, like on the set and off the set. You know,
yeah,
we definitely took
totally.
some tools that we would put into productions of our own, you know, like with the workshopping of the script and being welcoming with all, you know, your home if you need,
yeah,
if you need, or like with a cast, you know, working on it and like throwing stuff at the wall, changing the script if it calls for it, you know, not holding anything too tight or
yeah,
to the heart, you know, letting other blood seep through, you
yeah,
know, the project and making each part a little bit of everybody.
And to just like, you know, trust yourself and, you know, from a directorial point of view, if I ever do work as a director, to trust your actors and cast a group of people that you want to work with.
Oh, congratulations on this film.
Thank you, Tim.
Looks like you guys had a blast making it.
Yeah.
And good luck going on in the future.
Thank you very much.
We've been talking with the stars of the new film, Everybody Wants Some, coming to a theater near you very soon. Be sure to go out and see it. It's a lot of fun, really funny, take you back to the 80s. For the Spiel on Entertainment, I'm Tim Astilos.
You gotta tune in, man.
Do you guys want to try a little telepathic stuff?
Do it.
Lock in.
What am I thinking about?
Baseball. Having a tail.
Cereal.
Same as sharks.
Sharks have tails.
That's a good point. That's a good point.
I wish I had a tail.
Yeah. That'd be awesome. Everybody.